In Pune, India, a young pregnant woman is counseled to go to a clinic when her baby comes. Most births here happen at home, risking complications like uncontrollable bleeding with no medical help.
It's very difficult to get her transported to the hospital within time, and in the process also the mother can die.
In fact, postpartum hemorrhage is the world's leading cause of women dying in childbirth. Nearly all of those deaths in poor countries, where fast quality care is far less available than in wealthy nations.
So women understand that when they get pregnant, they're definitely putting their lives at risk.
And when a mother dies from bleeding, her baby is 10 times less likely to survive to age 2. No single approach will stop the 500,000 maternal deaths each year, but there are simple and cost-effective interventions that could keep women alive. The medicine oxytocin can effectively prevent and treat postpartum hemorrhage. And PATH, with funding from the U.S. Agency for International Development, has pioneered a way to administer a precise dose of oxytocin and save new moms, even in the most remote locations.
This is a technology we developed in a shop called Uniject.
The Uniject is a small, pre-filled plastic bubble attached to a syringe. With just a squeeze, an injection can be given by even a minimally skilled midwife.
All you have to do is click and it's activated.
This technology makes it easy to carry and store the medicine and to use it quickly. Birth attendants have only seconds to give oxytocin to save the mother. With Uniject, there's no fumbling with bottles and syringes. And studies conducted by USAID and other institutions have shown that oxytocin and Uniject can be used effectively in poor countries. Imagine the potential impact of increasing access to this and other promising, low-cost, life-saving measures on women and babies around the world who so urgently need the help.
What more can you ask for to have that tool that gives you the chance to help and keep life and bring new life and not to have to bury some woman for postpartum hemorrhage that is preventable and easily treated?